For more than 50 years, one woman has been at the heart of Britain's great national crises and her own personal family turmoil. She has shaped the nation from behind closed doors. Her story is all our stories. On the day of her coronation, the Queen's solemn face hid a dark secret that was about to break out and shock the watching world. Her 22-year-old sister Margaret was having an affair with a divorced royal servant. Now, previously unseen documents reveal a new story of what really happened, how close Margaret came to a marriage that threatened the monarchy, and how the Queen, far from being a bystander, took a more decisive role than anyone has realized. This is how the Queen came of age, learning that to survive she must wield power not just in public, but in private. While King George was alive, there were two princesses, Elizabeth and Margaret. But the happy days of the royal family weren't destined to last.
This is London. It is with the greatest sorrow that we make the following announcement.
On the 6th of February 1952, their lives changed forever. Summoned from a royal tour of Kenya, Elizabeth returned to Britain as Queen. For a 25-year-old, it was a daunting prospect. Waiting for her was her sister Margaret, who'd been with their father when he died.
He was very loved. It was tragic, and she worshipped her father, so tears flowed from everyone, as far as I remember.
My condolences, ma'am. Such a great man. The princess has been asking after you since yesterday.
Margaret? Margaret?
I've been waiting for you.
I'm sorry. Your Majesty. Now, now, up you get. Oh, you look so tired.
We listened to your tour on the wireless. Papa was so proud.
And of you.
He was out all day shooting. Making jokes over dinner. I thought he was getting better.
You have to rest. And I must go and see Tommy. Shall I send for the doctor? I'll give you something to calm you.
Why are you going?
So much to do. I'm sorry, I'll come to you later.
Naturally, they were both very, very sad. But I think maybe Princess Margaret, she had another reason to be sad. She said, well, you know, I've lost my father, and in a way, I've lost my sister up to a point, because our lives have completely changed.
the time of the king's death, one in three people in Britain believed the new queen was chosen by God. Not only head of state and head of the British Commonwealth, Elizabeth became supreme governor of the Church of England. The young queen was surrounded by old men with old-fashioned values.
State documents, ma'am. If you kindly sign them.
Thank you, Tommy.
Her key advisor was her father's private secretary, Sir Alan Lascelles, known to all by his nickname, Tommy.
Arrangements to move Your Majesty's family here at Buckingham Palace will be made immediately.
So soon? But we're very happy in Clarence House.
If you'll forgive me, ma'am, to ensure a smooth transition, you and your family must move as soon as possible to Buckingham Palace. It will be for the Princess and the Queen Mother to move to Clarence House. When you and they are ready, of course.
But my mother has no great wish to leave, nor does my sister. It is their home.
It is because, if you'll forgive me, ma'am, the king understood the importance of being here. To take any other course of action would be utterly impractical and unprecedented.
Very well. Can we spare telling Margaret for a little while, Tommy?
Of course.
Princess Margaret had a very different role to play. Her sister, who she adored, became sort of remote from her in a way because she had so many duties to carry out. Whereas I think Princess Margaret felt all the time that she was slightly sidelined.
Devoted sisters. I mean, the Queen adored Princess Margaret and she wanted her to be happy. She really did. As I was younger than her, we used to play together and she was quite naughty, actually, Princess Margaret. We used to have great fun. Princess Elizabeth was sort of more solemn. She was always saying, "Oh, Margaret, you can't do that."
They were very, very different characters. Princess Margaret was up for a good time. I think that she enjoyed being rebellious. She did quite a lot of her rebelling just to show the world that she was going to do what she wanted and that she was going to behave really badly if she felt like it. Lord, help the mister who comes between me.